Half a day, everyone. My name is Michelle Pier. I'm an artist and the owner of Creative Indeed. You can follow my art and events and everything else at creativeindeed.net. You can also find me on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. Today I'm going to be doing a painting demonstration on how to paint a Latte stone. And you've probably seen some of my time-lapse videos where I do a painting from start to finish and it's sped up like 20 times. This time I'm doing it in real time and I'm going to explain my process as I go and just kind of share with you how I do a painting from start to finish. This particular piece is going to be an sort of abstract. I'm going to do a Latte stone, which as you can see here, this is a Latte stone. You can Google it and learn about the history of Guam and the Marianas culture with Latte stones. So I want to do a metallic background, kind of a sunset palette tone. So these are the colors that I have: gold, bronze, metallic orange, metallic red, and metallic pearl white. This is a sponge, a little artist's sea sponge. So I'm just gonna get the sponge wet. So I'm gonna dip it into the water and kind of squeeze out the excess. Just get it saturated. Okay, so these metallic paints that I'm using are Chroma brand. I like them. They're pretty. They have a pretty liquidy consistency. Not a heavy body kind of paint. I use all acrylics, by the way. So everything I'll be doing is with acrylic paint. Okay. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with my lightest color, which is the pearl white, and that's going to be the center. So I'm just going to kind of I took all my paint out, by the way, out of the palette. I just scooped it all onto that sponge. And then I'm just going to kind of start. I want the brightest part to be right here. So I'm just, and this is where the Latte stone is going to be, by the way. So I'm going to have it glowing kind of behind it, all this pearl white. And I don't want to be very smooth about it. I like a rougher texture with my paintings. But if you want, you can be smooth with the sponge. You can smooth it out more, but I like to keep some of that rougher texture in there. Just gonna keep kind of going like that. Get this full-on glow happening around here, so it's not just white canvas. I try not to keep this same texture as I go. I like to do different things. As you can see now, I'm kind of doing a stroke with that instead. Just give it a little bit of variety and depth. Okay, now we're gonna work in the gold, which is my favorite color. If you haven't noticed, you can see in the painting behind me these gold reflections. Like my favorite color to use, so I might have a little bit of an addiction to gold paint. Here we go. I'm just gonna get some of this with the sponge. There's a lot on there. Work in all that gold. Come around. And the reason why I did that is because I want this kind of saturated gold on the edges, but I'm gonna slowly work some of this in and out. Now I do want more water because I want to blend it a little more into the white. I'll just go on and on doing this for a while. Sponge some of that in just to cover some background. I'm changing my texture now, doing more of these smooth lines. Okay, I'm gonna start working in some of this metallic orange. Look at that. Super orange, metallic gold. We'll do some darker colors kind of around the sides here. Okay, You gotta keep looking at the whole piece to kind of see where you want to even out some spots, and you know, don't try and be perfect or too precise about it. That's the beauty of abstract art, is you can have a little more freedom in your movements if that's your style of art. Some abstract art is very precise, so it just depends on the style you're going for. Mixing this on that side. Into the middle a little bit here, just to make some variations that'll make this pop out a bit more. Sometimes I'll come and put a little dark color somewhere around the brightest part so that it really stands out in the end. All right, let's keep going with that. I'm gonna do more gold and that bronze. Oh man, my pink is out. I'm just going to get a whole bunch of this on my sponge again and work in these bottom areas here. In my metallic red. This is going to really, really stand out on this. So I'm going to be a little more careful about where I put this color. Maybe some highlights up there and around. A little bit there. Some down here. I like doing that where you have just a little bit up there and then a darker, bigger piece down here. Kind of brings the piece into balance a bit. Composition, if you want to get into that. This is going to be a work in progress. Getting all that blended. Okay, so when you have a darker color like this, I told you it's going to really stand out against this gold. And what I'm going to do to really work it in there and get it a bit more blended, I'm going to come back with more gold paint and kind of work this in a bit more. Okay, I'm going to get a little water on my sponge again so I can start bringing some of this color down here. Okay, and I'm just trying to work a little faster because I know some of my other paint up there is starting to dry. So you got to kind of be aware of what steps you're in. That's the blessing and the curse of acrylics, is that they do dry pretty quickly. Right. And then I'm going to bring back the gold in the end. Not yet, though. I'll get a few more blending. So come kind of to the edges of where it's dark and rough and sort of blend it in a bit more. Okay, so I'm just getting a little bit more of the gold paint and kind of work back some of changes. Awesome, right? Okay, I'm gonna work in some of the darker bronze. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm coming back now with my metallic orange paint, and I'm doing a little bit more of a smooth motion with my sponge, just to give it a little bit of a shape beyond just the background texture that we did. Maybe just smooth around here. Okay, we're back, and I'm going to be doing the Latte Stone part now. And so, what I did, I've got every color of my metallics here, and so I'm going to kind of just do this sort of rainbow metallic effect. And I'm not even sure which side I want to start with, because I might make one side less obvious. Okay, and I'm going to use this big brush. This is the experimental part. This is where you gotta be just kinda, don't be afraid to try new things even if people are watching. Silver on that side. I'm getting the different colors on the brush as I do this. So I'm getting the silver and the red on there. At the same time pulling this gold, I want a little bit of all of it on there. Save me. Trying not to mix them though at the same time. And I want really thick paint. You can see that it's a really thick glob of paint on there. See that, how it does that? Okay, so I'm playing with this as I go. I'm trying to kind of, now that I put these really bold, obvious lines and textures on here, to make it kind of a cohesive piece. Now I have to work back some of the elements of the original texture that I did under it to not make it feel like I just threw these lines on there and that's the end. So I'm going to bring back the gold and kind of highlight around these. Finish this line. Bring that in there. Okay, so I'm just building on layers so that you can see kind of how it comes together. It takes a while for a piece to become cohesive and you're happy to call it finished. Let me see if I can show what it looks like. Pull that down, you can see more of the colors. Okay, it's feeling a little more done now. See how, okay, I know it's hard to see in the screen, but see how just those subtle little extra lines against the background texture sort of brings it together more where it's kind of a cohesive piece and not just this bold lattice stone sitting on top of this background texture. So I think I'm a little happier with that. I think I'm gonna call it done for now. I have a tendency to come back to it later when everything's dry and make more little embellishments, but I like this piece. It's an abstract lattice stone, and I'll be doing more demos like this. Someone asked me if I can do actual painting demos, not just my time-lapse videos, so this is for you. Hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to check out creativeindeed.net. Follow me on Instagram, creative_indeed, or also on here on YouTube, as well as Facebook. Yeah, you can sign up for my weekly e-zine on the website, creativeindeed.net, if you want to receive weekly updates to the latest artworks like this. You'll hear about it first there. My e-zine subscribers get my best treatment, so check it out. Thank you.